On the corner of Dave Niehaus Way and Edgar Martinez Drive, welcome to T-Mobile Park. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Houston Astros taking on the Seattle Mariners. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. So just about set now, and now it's going to be Jose Altuve. And a 1-1. To the right side. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And a quick out number one. And Michael Brantley is going to come up to hit. Out to short. Crawford throws to first in time. Two quick outs at the top of the first here tonight. Two outs, bases empty. Now it's Alex Bregman. Next offering is down low.
We got two balls, one strike.
And there's a strike. 2-2 now. Stays alive. Righty to the plate. And he gets Bregman. That's out number three. Bottom of the first. Here's Adam Frazier. That one drilled left field, lays out and makes the play.
Batting second, the first baseman, John
Brent. Now the number two hitter, Ty France. Falling behind 2-1. The wind and the pitch. Good eye right there. Kicks and deals. He swings and fouls one off. One down, base is empty. And that one is lifted in the air. McCormick on his way over. Racing makes the catch. Two up, two down. Here's Jesse Winker singing game five of elimination spot, and the spotlight is focused on this guy.
Everybody looks to the star players in big games like this, and this is what you get paid for. Time to come through.
Out of line, out towards center. McCormick makes the catch, and that'll do it. Second inning set to go. Now here's the Astros designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. And he deals. Fouls one off. 2-2. And there's a ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
And a 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. The 1-1. There's a strike. At the belt and fires. Pitch misses. And that's ball two. Hit on the ground, might be two. Fired to second. On to first, double play. Here's Kyle Tucker. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
The next offering misses. Ball two. Righty delivers. And it's fouled away. Next offering is fouled back. Next one misses, and that's ball three.
You see how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Got him. And that is that. Bottom half of inning number two, and here is Mitch Haniger. The pitch. On the ground, and he grabs it foul. And a pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Here's a 2-2. Got him. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now.
Eugenio Suarez.
No score here in the second. Pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
Stays alive.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Tucker makes his way towards it, hauls it in after a long run. Two down.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
And the right-hander deals.
Two balls, two strikes.
Out to short. In time to Gurriel. Inning over. Welcome back. Top half of the third inning. Digging in, Chaz McCormick. The pitch. Swings through that one.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there and just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
And that's a base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff dot.
Hey, whatever works, right? Doesn't have to be impressive. I think he made his pitch on the mound. Two-strike count, made him chase way outside the zone, but just couldn't get him to miss, and somehow he found a way to put it in play for the knock.
Now, Jeremy Peña. The next pitch misses, 2-1. And the righty deals. Smash to the left side, and that's just foul. Next pitch just misses. Counts full, 3-2. And here comes.
That
And that's the first out. Martin Maldonado up to hit.
The catcher, Martin Maldonado.
And a pitch. Swings and misses. Back-to-back strikeouts. So digging in, Jose Altuve grounded out his first time. McCormick, the runner at first with two gone. Next pitch, not close, up high.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Next pitch downstairs, 3-1. Started at the 3-1, now a check, and down to first we go. No swing, he held up. Darryl Parker with the call there. So first and second with two outs. Now Michael Brantley steps in. Two outs. That one fouled off, 2-2. The pitch. Next offering misses down and away.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Here comes a 3-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch. Line drive, that's a base hit. Runner around third. He scores and they have the lead. 1-0.
Well done, drives in the run. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
And now it's Alex Bregman. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Back here at the ballpark, this is Kyle Lewis. The wide to kick the pitch. And a foul ball. Next one off the plate inside. Two balls, two strikes. The wind of the pitch. The punch out there, and there's one down. Here's Jared Kelnick.
The left fielder, Jared Kelnick.
Swing and a miss. And the count's even at 2. Left-hand batter waits. Foul ball there. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
Next offering is fouled back. Line drive, short hop to third. Here's the tag, and he's out. Two outs, base is empty. So here's Murphy now. And a pitch. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Here comes a pitch. Stays alive. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and that will end the inning. back in Seattle, here's Yordan Alvarez. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Next offering misses, and the count is 2-2. That one hammered left field. That's back there. And it's a one-hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. And that's a leadoff double.
Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
Now it's Yuli Gurriel. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. The run comes in to score from second, and they take a two-run lead. It's an RBI double, and it's 2-0.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. He got a pitch he could drive, but he didn't get too excited like a lot of guys do and pull off the baseball. Really good timing all the way through the swing, and the barrel was so on plane with the ball. Easy drive into the gap for that double.
One down. And next to hit for Houston, Chaz McCormick. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. Runner at second here, one gone. And the next pitch is way outside. And now it's filled up. Kicks and fires. Now fly ball to right center. Haniger settles under this one. Makes the catch. And there are two outs. And now the shortstop, Jeremy Pena. Here's a 1-1. There's a line drive to left field. Can't get there. Base hit. Lewis throws to second. The tag out. But one run does score on the play before the inning ends. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now it's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. Next pitch inside. And a count 2-1. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2.
Good pitch right there. Tied him up on the hands. If I'm out there on the bump, I'm going right back in there.
Next offering upstairs.
Now in this three ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
And down on strikes he goes. And there's one down. Ty France will hit next. And a pitch. That one misses, and that's ball two.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
The next offering misses. And now 3-1.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
And now a full count. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Wind of the pitch. This one lifted in the air, left field. Brantley gets under it, snags it for the second out. Two outs, base is empty. At the plate, Jesse Winker. The M's yet to pick up a hit here. In the air, out to center. And Winker is set down. And that is the third out of the inning. back at T-Mobile Park, ready now for the fifth inning. And now here is Martin Maldonado. Here's a 1-1. And a foul ball. Bounce to third. Gathers and throws to first. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth. Here's the former MVP, Jose Altuve. Hey. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. That one missed. And he deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. That one down the line. Throws to first. And the first two set down on the top of the fifth. Here's Michael Brantley.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, it will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. Could be extra bases. Now he turns and heads for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Just a bloop hit behind third right there, and that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
Here's Alex Bregman. That hits the dirt. Now two balls and a strike. Out towards right center field, Haniger sizes this one up, brings it in, and the inning is over. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now batting Mitch Haniger. Right-hander kicks, deals.
This hitter's looking for a fastball, but I'm not sure he's going to get one. Pitcher doesn't have to challenge him. If he feels better about his off-speed secondary stuff, then stay with it.
Maldonado moving under it, hauls it in for the out. Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
But we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slug is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strikeout concerns.
Next pitch is outside. The Mariners still looking for their first hit in this one. In the air, left side. Brantley drifts towards it. He's got it. And there's two down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Next one is off the play. Two balls and a strike.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Next pitch is outside. Righty to the plate. Lifted in the air, right center field. McCormick under it. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that's the third out. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Anthony Misevich.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
All set for the top of the sixth. Now it's the DH, Yordan Alvarez. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. And a pitch. puts it in the air out towards left center. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. He's in with a double, and that's his second double of the night.
Here's Gurriel.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
And now the lefty stays alive. Alvarez stands at second with no outs. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Coming around third is Alvarez. Throw home, he beats it, and it's 4-0.
Gotta love the resiliency he showed in that at bat, battling with two strikes. Wasn't able to elevate that one, but he sure hit it hard enough to get through the infield. There's not a whole lot of time for the defenders to react and try to make a play when it's ripped like that.
That misses, 2-1. There's a swing and a miss. Left-hand hitter waits. Meanwhile, this pitch gets away. Runner holds, and it's a full count. Runner at first with no outs here. There's a swing and a drive. That one carrying. Gone! Kyle Tucker sends it out, and they add on. It's 6-0. Justice Sheffield takes over on the mound. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is. Chaz McCormick up next for the Astros. The pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And here it comes.
Nope, that's a ball.
On the ground to first, and he grabs it in foul ground. Next pitch is outside. Kicks and fires. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Kelnick brings it in, one away.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay closed.
So next up for Houston, Jeremy Pena. And here's a 3-2. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle to base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
And now Martin Maldonado. And fouled off. And a pitch stays alive. The 2-2. Runner takes off on the ground right side. Base hit. That was smoked through the infield. To third, not in time. And it's runners at the corners with one gone. Jose Altuve up to hit here. Lefty out of the stretch. Runners at first and third. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The kick, the 3-2. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And a payoff pitch. On the ground, 2-2. And he'll be safe at first. One down. Michael Brantley up next for the Astros. Next offering in the dirt, and now 3-1. the pitch. This ball's chopped on the ground. Gets it to first, and they get Brantley for the out. Now the third baseman, Alex Bregman.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Next pitch is inside, and it's 2-1. And another ball. Maldonado on third. Altuve at second with two gone. Hit hard. That gets through. The throw is offline, and he's in to score. And it's an 8-run lead. Another scores. Two runs in on the play. It's 9-0.
Gets the job done as he brings home a pair. Just a simple ground ball the other way. They had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Righty reliever out of the pen, Eric Swanson. And we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big. Runner at first with two away. Next is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. And the right-hander deals. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
So up next, Yuli Gurriel. Next offering is in for a strike. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. And down on strikes goes Gurriel. Ends the inning after they racked up a bunch of runs. Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth inning. And stepping in for the Mariners, Kyle Lewis.
Well, every pitcher wants run support, and having a lead is nice, but it can be challenging for some guys. I think keeping the mindset to attack instead of trying to be too fine and have too much finesse, go after hitters and get quick outs.
Out to short, Pena collects it. One away, bottom of the sixth. Here's the left fielder, Jared Kelnick, grounded out his first time. The M's hitless so far in the game. Into center. Drops into the glove, two away. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Tom Murphy. Next offering upstairs. The pitch stays alive. Fly ball down the line. Tucker moving back for this one. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Well, got to pause on that thought, as that'll do it for the inning. Top of inning number 7, and stepping in for the Astros, Kyle Tucker. And that one almost got him. Here's a 2-1. That one is upstairs. Ripped on the ground a second. Frazier over to pick it up. Over to first. One up, one down. And stepping in is the speedy Chaz McCormick. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. The pitch. That one hammered center field. That's back there. Hauls it in on the warning track. Stepping in, Jeremy Pena.
The shortstop, Jeremy Pena.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Popped up. Suarez should have this one. Makes the grab, and that is that. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now for Seattle, Ty France. The wind of the pitch. In the air, left field. Brantley on the move as he glides back. And he makes the catch. And there's one away. And next is the designated hitter, Jesse Winker.
99 pitches, about to throw his 100th here in the seventh inning. This is where you really start looking for any signs of fatigue.
On the ground, right side. Whips it to first. Fine play in the hole for the out. Now it's going to be Mitch Haniger. Two outs. Oh, now this is drilled to center. Way back there. On its way and gone. Mitch Haniger leaves the yard. His second homer of this series, and they inch closer. It's 9-1. The Astros turn to a new arm on the mound, Hector Neris, and a healthy-sized lead for him to go to work with. So two away with nobody on. Here's a big power threat. Eugenio Suarez. Next pitch is downstairs.
The count is 3-1.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Boom, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Righty delivers. Got him looking. Good job at damage control right there. Ready to begin the eighth. Here's the catcher, Martin Maldonado. Swings through that.
One ball, two strikes.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Next pitch in the dirt. Now 2-2. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a line drive caught. Jose Altuve up next for the Astros. And the pitch. And a strike in there. One and two now. Altuve waits. And now it's even up. The pitch. In the air, right field. Haniger makes the play. Two away now. Two outs, base is empty. Michael Brantley, the next to hit. Away to kick the pitch. And downstairs. The wind and the pitch. Center field. Lewis settles under it. And makes the play, and that's out number three. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. Here's the center fielder, Kyle Lewis. The 3-1. On the inside corner for a strike. And he deals. Liner picked on the hop at first. Got him on the off-balance throw. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. Jared Kelnick now at the plate. And a pitch.
Ball two.
Nasty backdoor slider. There's really nothing you can do with that if you swing at it. So that's a good take by him.
Strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Here comes a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. That's the second out.
Now batting.
And now, Tom Murphy. Right-hander kicks, deals. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Righty to the plate. In the air, right side of the infield. Gurriel handles the chance. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Sergio Romo. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do. And welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Here's the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Kicks and fires.
That's a ball.
And he walked him.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Now it's Yordan Alvarez. Bregman aboard here at first with nobody out. In the air, left field. Kelnick settles underneath it, makes the grab, one down. Yuli Gurriel up next for the Astros. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is... That's a laser base hit. Here comes Bregman around third. Crawford with a relay home, and he's out. So a man aboard, and now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. And a 3-1 on the way. And now the count filled up 3-2.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Right side, Frazier collects in plenty of time to first. That's the third out. Back now as they hand the ball to a fresh arm to start the bottom of the ninth, Blake Taylor. And he'll try to keep this big lead right where it is. We head to the bottom of the ninth. Here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier.
Hanging in there pretty good against the lefty.
And a pitch. In the air, right field, pretty well struck. That's back there. Ty France up next for the Mariners. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. And now the lefty. And a foul ball.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. And now the DH, Jesse Winker. The pitch. And 1-2. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. One out. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Ryan Stanek. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. And up next for Seattle, Mitch Haniger. Next offering is in for a strike. And a pitch. Stays alive. Still only one out here in the inning. Now with the shift on, hits right into it. And they take care of Haniger for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Eugenio Suarez up next for the Mariners. Two two now. Good eye right there.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
Throw to first, ball game, and the Astros slug their way to a win in this one.
Key to this game was that huge sixth inning. They jumped all over the opposing pitching, and it was like they knew what was coming. And that kind of confidence just takes a team to the finish line, and that's what they did. They got the win in this game.
Three, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
ends our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros, 9 runs, 14 hits. No errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Mariners, 3 runs, 4 hits, 1 error. They left 2 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 27 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at T-Mobile Park, 47,715. The Mariners thank you for your patronage and remind you to please buckle up and drive home safely.